Get ready to match the stars. Bill Cullen, Brett Somers, Jack Klugman, Cass Elliott, Richard Dawson, and Loretta Swit as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
I thought a brief brisk swim before the show would be nice. Pretty deep pool, though. Hello there. Are they ready, John?
Ready.
Okay, we're ready, too. Are you ready over here on the
line?
Yes.
Are you ready on the firing line? Let's say hello to our two players, Eleanor Proley and Bill Goldstein. Eleanor's our current champ. She's won a lot of money. How much money have you won?
$5,600.
$5,600. What are you going to do with that?
Spend it fast.
You're going to spend it fast? Okay. Well, we're almost ready to start a game. We ought to find out who this fellow is, Bill Goldstein. Tell us where you're from, Bill.
Well, I went to school in Oregon, and I live in West L.A. now, and I teach at a junior college.
What do you teach?
Social sciences. This semester, I'm teaching economics.
All right. Good luck to you, Bill.
I may take that up.
You may take that up.
Great.
We'll start this game right after we finish these messages. That's the way it goes.
Economics.
I know that you and Eleanor will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities. The one who's done that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner, and have a go at the super match where you can win over $5,000. Now, some of our contestants find some questions harder than others. That's why we put it up to you. Make a selection, please.
I'll take B.
He wants B. Here it is, folks.
And
everybody, please.
And I'll give her away at the wedding.
That's another show. The old gambler warned, never play poker with Raquel. She always keeps a pair of aces in her blank. You do too, madam.
Look, I'm the first one through. That's the first time that's ever happened.
Yes, everybody's ready. Oh, you didn't take long at all in making up your mind there. Bill, we ask your response now. Never play poker with Raquel. She always keeps a pair of aces in her...
I can only visualize chest.
In her chest.
No, well, bra, really.
You don't
that's
need
what
checkers
I mean.
Bra, here.
Right?
Yeah. Oh, you mean bra.
I mean bra, right.
Okay, bra is your answer. Okay. Bra is his answer.
Bra is his answer?
I mean, he can't say chest with a lady. What's wrong with you? He hasn't been around much. He's very young. Yeah. What do you say?
I'm sorry. I like him young.
He said bra.
He said bra, that's his answer.
Yeah, that's enough there for a full house. A pair of aces. I cleaned it up a little bit and got bodice out of it. I don't know. It's the same place.
No, that is not a bodice. Is a thing that comes down here. Laces up in the back here.
That's
a bodice.
You're talking about the old-fashioned
town. Yeah, all right, Brett, what do you say?
Actually, that's where she parks her car.
In her bodice? Yeah.
Well, in her cleavage.
That's in her cleavage. No, Brad.
There,
oh, that did match.
Well, of course, that's a...
Well, I don't know. I was waiting for the ding dong.
Yeah, there it is. All I wish is, boy, that this was the ace of clubs and this was the ace of diamonds.
Yeah. What say you, lady?
I say blouse.
In her blouse.
You
no
do?
Man?
Ah, you're smart. Why would you say that?
Okay, Richard, we need a response from you.
Yeah, whatever you play, by the way, poker with Raquel, you need
two jacks are better to open, so I put bra.
I wasn't going to say jack.
Yes.
Now, Loretta.
I'm definitely in the wrong area. Garter.
Oh, in the garter.
Well, I used to...
We weren't talking about Marlena Dietrich here.
That's Gin Rummy.
Poker's here.
Okay, I would like to make a statement.
You didn't do too bad with that, Bill Goldstein. You got three, and now let's see how Eleanor, our current champ, does with this. If the pilgrims had landed at the North Pole, your mother would spend Thanksgiving stuffing a blank. If the pilgrims had landed at the North Pole, your mother would spend Thanksgiving stuffing a blank.
Do you think I've smartened up as the weeks have gone
I think
by?
You're doing very well, and I love the way you're wearing your hair. You look stunning, my dear.
Wait, she'll give it to you. You'll
All right, everybody ready over there. Elena, you're thinking deeply about this, are you?
Yes.
How would you fill that in? If the pilgrims had landed at the North Pole, your mother would spend Thanksgiving stuffing a...
an Eskimo. Well, I can think of from Alaska, the North Pole, yeah, an Eskimo.
You don't have to explain it, Diane. Bad enough as it is. She says,
I heard
Eskimo. It's the most winning answer we've had on the show in 17 weeks here. All right, Bill. If you say Eskimo...
You can do it, Bill.
Penguin.
Penguin, yeah.
My mother's stuck in Eskimo.
Really? All right, Brett, what did you say?
Actually, I think Eleanor has it the wrong way round, but who am I to criticize? Seal.
A seal? Okay. You haven't got an Eskimo yet, Eleanor. We're trying for you, though.
Eleanor, I've had an Eskimo, and you know, they're not so
strong. Penguin.
All right. Now, Cass Elliott.
Actually, this is known as the turkey of the north, the penguin.
The turkey of the north, yes. All right.
What's the seal?
One glass of wild penguin. That's a little Texas joke. No, actually, penguins are what they stuff. And I did that once when I was a little tipsy. Turned out it was a head waiter, but the thought was there, wasn't it?
That's the turkey of the show.
I see they, well, you lay him, Jack, and I'll sell him.
Okay. Another penguin. So we had all penguins and no Eskimos, sorry to say, Eleanor. So at the end of round one, it's 3-0 in favor of the challenger. We'll go to round two after we go to these messages for you. Okay, here we go with round two. If you're all ready, Bill, would you make a selection?
I'll take B.
B is what he wants, and last time out, Bill, you matched three celebrities, Brett, Jack, and Richard, so the three of you will not participate, the
you
others
mean
will.
You tell me I can't get on his side again?
No. Nobody knows this, but William Shakespeare did all of his writing in the blank.
I have a good answer.
There's the question. You get it, Bill? Nobody knows this, but William Shakespeare did all of his writing in the blank. You're out.
I don't care. I'm going to play over
the blank. All right. You're ready, Bill, are you? Did you finish?
I'm as ready as I'll ever be. I'll put my little thing right. I always forget this.
Okay, there we go. Now we get a response from Bill Goldstein. Nobody knows this, but William Shakespeare did all of his writing in the...
in the... John.
And John? You know, if we had the time, I'd ask you to describe what a John looked like in those days, because I don't think they had them, do they? I don't know. He says the John.
Yeah, it means in a forest.
In
that
a
was
John?
Sure.
Yeah.
A rose by any other name would smell as sweet.
Oh, look at that. Okay.
I know I'm not playing, but I said raw.
In the raw. All right, Cass, you're playing.
In the nude.
In the nude. In the, all right. And now we go to Loretta.
They most certainly had them in those days. John.
All right. To each his own. So, Bill, you're up to five. Now, Eleanor, you've got to match five celebrities to achieve a tie. Six will win the game. Listen carefully now.
Roses are red, violets are blue. The meatloaf you served me tastes exactly like...
Wait. You must have come over to our house for dinner. Come over, turn over.
Are you contemplating your...
My navel.
Oh, I see. There she is. Okay, she's out of it now. You're finished, right, Brett? Okay.
What?
You're finished.
Yeah, everybody finished. Oh, your light was on, and I... All right. Now, Eleanor, roses are red, violets are blue. The meatloaf you served me tastes exactly like...
Glue.
The audience thinks the winning answer is glue. Let's see what you said, Bill Cullen.
Comes to show what the audience knows. Glue.
Glue. All right, Brett.
Well, there are a lot of things that rhyme with blue, but glue's best.
There's two.
Two for glue. What are you supposed to taste any other way but by glue?
Glue. Need two more to tie. Three to win, Cass.
I'm embarrassed. A shoe?
Shoe.
I love you, Cass.
That's all right. She's okay.
If any trouble, she's going to come over and fall on the front row. Now,
that's my friend.
All right.
That was a dumb answer.
Yeah. You must match the two remaining celebrities, and let's see if it happens.
I think a very sticky response.
Glue. All right. One more for a tie, and it's up to you, Loretta.
Oh, the pressure. Well, I was a little more kind about her cooking. I said stew.
Stew. So the winner is Bill Goldring. Come on down, Bill. All right, there's $100 for you, together with our congratulations. Stand by for a moment while we tell Eleanor that she's going to be leaving here with $5,600 and our best wishes.
Thank you.
Eleanor Crowley. Thank you. Bye, Eleanor. Okay. Well, Bill, you've been around here long enough to know how it goes, so shall we have a go at it?
All right. Let's see what happens.
Sure. Let's see what happens. Cool, Cat.
Both of you get out of here. Go on.
Bill, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Rip blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, if you can match it. Second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. Okay, now, three celebrities are allowed to give a little help. Name one.
Richard.
Rip Van Winkle. Ah, shut up.
All right, another one?
Brett.
Rip off.
Rip off. Okay.
Cass.
Cass Elliott?
Rip cord.
Rip cord. So, you've got Rip Van Winkle, rip off, and rip cord. You may give us one of those as the answer, or another one if you'd like, one of your own.
I'm going to go with Rip Van Winkle.
Okay. He wants to go with Rip Van Winkle.
You'll like him. He's a nifty old dancer.
I went with him for years.
Yeah.
He was okay.
He has a very long beard.
A little hairy, but what the heck. Okay, Rip Van Winkle is the answer he's looking for, and that's what we're all looking for. So let's find out if it's under the $100 response. Rip Torn is an answer that none of us thought about.
Quickly they forget
it.
Yes.
It's a so-so answer there. Okay. We're still looking for a Rip Van Winkle. Here is the $250 response. Rip off is up there. That's the one Brett gave you. Okay. Third and last chance for Rip Van Winkle. Where are you, Rip? Are you under the $500 response?
Yes.
Yes, you are.
Congratulations.
Okay. Now, Bill, you're up to $600. You've won the $500 here. That means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to... Yeah, you want to open your jacket for that?
Why don't you take it off, sweetheart?
Now, to get the $5,000, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis, and the time has come to choose that person.
Well, I'm going to go with Richard.
Sure. Yeah.
Thank God.
Okay.
I must warn you, I don't kiss on the first date.
You'd be better than Rip Van Winkle.
Well, thank you.
You kissed me on the first date, Vicki.
All right. Rip Van Winkle did.
He's going to get ready to... You face me. Just stand right there like that. Okay. Here is the $5,000 question. Richard, write your answer to this, if you would, please. Apple blank. Apple blank. Okay, he's finished his answer. Now, Bill, it's time for us to give us your answer. How do you fill in the blank? Apple?
Pie.
Okay. That seems to be the favorite with the audience. Richard, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
All the trouble I had at school, I never thought I'd write pie for school.
Who's that screaming and hooping and hollering? You got a friend there?
I've got a couple of friends out there.
Okay. What plans do you have for your money, if any?
A trip.
Where?
I was thinking of maybe, Carnival in Rio, something like that. How about that?
Okay, let's go, shall we? Listen, you've done very well. You're up to $5,600. You're still the champ. You're going to play another game. But first, we've got to pass along these messages. Now, what do you say we welcome this new player, Antoinette Osborne? Hi, Antoinette.
Hi. How are you doing?
Pretty lady, huh?
Yeah.
A very pretty lady. Where's this pretty lady from?
Los Angeles.
What do you do?
I keep my baby at home. I have a little six-month-old baby girl.
You have a six-month-old baby girl, and mm-hmm. she occupies all of your time.
Oh, yes.
I'll bet you're a good mother.
Yes.
Okay. Good luck to you here. You know that you and Bill will be answering questions, trying to match our celebrities, and the one who does that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner, and we'll have a go at the super match where you can win over $5,000. You ready?
Yes.
Okay, I'll push this button, which is here somewhere. There it is. And you're going to pick B. All right, she picked B.
All right, remember your marriage.
Yes, I am married. Okay. The Jolly Green Giant's belly button is so big, you can blank in it. Yeah.
I wish you were dead. I never doubted you for a second.
The Jolly Green Giant's belly button is so big, you can blank in it.
It's bizarre.
Bizarre. Antoinette, the Jolly Green Giant's belly button is so big you can blank in it.
Swim.
Swim. Okay, she says swim. It sounds okay to me. How does it sound to you, Bill?
I've never been all that active. I like to sleep there.
Go to sleep.
Just curl up and...
Yeah. Okay, you swim or you sleep, Brett.
Bill Cullen said when that girl came out, I love her act. I think that means he thinks she's pretty.
Yeah.
I can't imagine why.
Great, she's beautiful.
Make soup.
You can make soup in his belly button. Okay.
Some of the soup she makes tastes like she made it in his belly.
So I try to hide in it. You can hide in his belly button. No swim yet, Antoinette, I'm sorry to say. Let's see if we get a swimmer here, Cass.
His belly button is so big that you can swim in it.
Swim in it. All right.
Well, when I got there, it was the dry season, no water, so I just sat down.
Oh.
I felt silly, but what can you do in there?
Right.
You know what I mean?
No water.
Thank you.
You could have gone through the motions.
Oh, well, I always go through the motions. According to my divorce papers. Anyway.
Loretta?
I felt the same way Dick did. I sit.
You sit in the belly button.
I wish I'd been there at the same time.
Yes. So you've scored one match there, Antoinette, and we'll get to your end of this round, Bill. Well, first, we've got to pass along a message, and then you hurry back for more of Match Game 73. Okay. Well, I'm sorry to say we've run out of time, but I trust both of you will be back here to continue Match Game 73. Will you do that?
Good. Yeah. Look forward to seeing you. Look forward to seeing you next time.
Seeing you,
Gene.
Seeing you.
Three
I certainly look forward
Brett
to seeing
and the new Perry Mason.
Yes, Doc.
Jack and the Odd Couple.
I forgot to tell you, I can't make it tomorrow.
My card.
I didn't know I had to be back.
What are you...
Oh, it's just a note that came. It said Dick Van Dyke is at 9:30 Mondays. I don't know who that possibly could be for.
That's right.
I think he fell for it,
folks. On the Dick Van Dyke Show, did you know that?
I did know it because I'm Dick, you know, and that's well.
You hear this? Very good. Okay, Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73. Hoping you'll join us next time. Thank you for being with us.
Another episode of Match Game. Then don't miss two episodes of Family Feud on GSN, the network for games.
Don't those two girls look bubbly at the end?
They do look bubbly over there.
You need a spanking.
She's a freak.
This week on Poker Royale.
You better watch it.
Watch Christy Gaze's Kathy Liebert and Karina Jett take on Paul Wolfe, Antonio Esfandari, and Greg Raymer. Poker Royale Battle of the Sexes, hosted by Tom Likas and Kennedy, Friday at 9 on GSN.
21 reasons to watch World Series of Blackjack. World Series of Blackjack, Friday at 10 on GSN.
You're talking about the old-fashioned time.
Yeah, all right, Brett, what do you say?
Actually, that's where she parks her car.
In her bodice?
Well, in her cleavage.
In her cleavage. No, Brad.
There,
oh, that did match.
Well, of course, that's a...
Well, I don't know. I was waiting for the ding-dong. Well, yeah, there it is.
All I wish is, boy, that this was the ace of clubs and this was the ace of diamonds.
Yeah. What say you, lady?
I say blouse.
In her blouse.
No, you man. Do? Ah, you're
why would you say that?
Okay, Richard, we need a response from you.
Yeah, whenever you play, by the way, poker with Raquel, you need two jacks or better to open. So I put bra.
I wasn't going to say jack.
Yes. Now, Loretta.
I'm definitely in the wrong area. Garter.
Oh, in the garter.
Well, I
weren't talking about Malena Dietrich, you know.
That's Gin Rummy.
Poker's here.
Okay, I would like to make a statement.
You didn't do too bad with that, Bill Goldstein. You got three, and now let's see how Eleanor, our current champ, does with this. Mm. If the pilgrims had landed at the North Pole, your mother would spend Thanksgiving stuffing a blank. If the pilgrims had landed at the North Pole, your mother would spend Thanksgiving stuffing a blank.
Do you think I've smartened up as the weeks have gone
I think
by?
You're doing very well, and I love the way you're wearing your hair. You look stunning, my dear.
Wait, she'll give it to you. You'll join.
All right, everybody ready over there. Larry, you're thinking deeply about this, are you?
Yes.
How would you fill that in? If the pilgrims had landed at the North Pole, your mother would spend Thanksgiving stuffing a...
an Eskimo. All I can think of from Alaska.
At the end of the second round will be the winner and have a go at the super match where you can win over $5,000. Now, some of our contestants find some questions harder than others. That's why we put it up to you. Make a selection, please.
I'll take B.
He wants B. Here it is, folks.
And
everybody please.
And I'll give her away at the wedding.
That's another show. The old gambler warned, never play poker with Raquel. She always keeps a pair of aces in her blank. You do too, madam.
That's the first time that's ever happened.
Yes, everybody's ready. Oh, you didn't take long at all in making up your mind there. Bill, we ask your response now. Never play poker with Raquel. She always keeps a pair of aces in her...
I can only visualize chest.
In her chest.
No, well, bra. Really.
You don't
that's
need
what
checkers
I mean. Bra,
here.
Right? Yeah. Oh, you mean bra.
I mean bra, right.
Okay, bra is your answer. Okay. Bra is his answer.
Bra is his answer?
I mean, he can't say chest with a lady. What's wrong with you? He hasn't been around much. He's very young. Yeah. What do you say?
I'm sorry, I like him young.
He said bra.
He said bra, that's his answer.
Yeah, that's enough there for a full house.
A pair of aces.
I cleaned it up a little bit and got bodice out of it. I don't know. It's
bodice,
the same,
is a
same place.
No, it's no, that's not a, that is not a... A bodice is a thing that comes down here.
Oh, it's all goes right down. Down. Oh, that's a
bodice. Laces up in the back
that's
here.
That's a bodice.
That's a bodice. That is
mine doesn't lace in the back.
You... I'm from North Pole, an Eskimo.
You don't have to explain it, do you? Bad enough as it is. She says.
Yeah, I heard.
Eskimo. It's yeah. The most winning answer we've had on the show in 17 weeks here. All right, Bill. If you say Eskimo.
You can do it, Bill.
I am, no, penguin.
Penguin, yeah.
My mother's stuck in Eskimo.
Really? All right, Brett, what did you say?
Actually, I think Eleanor has it the wrong way round, but who am I to criticize? Seal.
A seal? Okay. Haven't got an Eskimo yet, Eleanor. We're trying for you, though.
Eleanor, I've had an Eskimo,
hope.
And you know, they're not so
strong. Okay. I got the stuff Brett Kellogg just brought. Penguin.
All right. Now, Cass Elliott.
Actually, this is known as the turkey of the north, the penguin.
The turkey of the north, yes. All right.
What's the seal?
One glass of wild penguin. That's a little Texas joke. No, actually, penguins are what they stuff. And I did that once when I was a little tipsy. Turned out it was a head waiter, but the thought was there, wasn't it?
That's the turkey of the show.
I see they... Well, you lay him, Jack, and I'll sell him.
Another penguin. So we had all penguins and no Eskimos, sorry to say, Eleanor. So at the end of round one, it's 3-0 in favor of the challenger. We'll go to round two after we go to these messages for you. Okay, here we go with round two. If you're all ready, Bill, would you make a selection?
I'll take B.
B is what he wants. And last time out, Bill, you matched 3 celebrities, Brett, Jack, and Richard, so the 3 of you will not participate, the
you
others
mean
will.
You tell me I can't get on his side again?
No. Nobody knows this, but William Shakespeare did all of his writing in the blank.
I have a good answer.
There's the question. You get it, Bill? Nobody knows this, but William Shakespeare did all of his writing in the blank.
You're out.
All right. You're ready, Bill, are you?
I'm as ready as I'll ever be. I'll put my little thing right. I always forget this.
Okay, there we go. Okay. Response from Bill Goldstein. Nobody knows this, but William Shakespeare did all of his writing in the...
In the... John.
In the John? You know, if we had the time, I'd ask you to describe what a John looked like in those days, because I don't think they had them, do they? I don't know. He says the John.
Yeah, it means in a forest.
In
that was
John?
Yeah. In the forest.
A rose by any other name would smell as sweet.
Oh, look at that. Okay.
I know I'm not playing, but I said raw.
In the raw. All right, Cass, you're playing.
In the nude.
In the nude. All right, and now we go to Loretta.
They most certainly had them in those days. John.
John! All right. To each his own. So, Bill, you're up to 5. Now, Eleanor, you've got to match 5 celebrities to achieve a tie. 6 will win the game. Listen carefully now. Roses are red, violets are blue. The meatloaf you served me tastes exactly like...
Must have come over to our house for dinner. Come over to know.
Get ready to match the stars. Bill Cullen, Brett Summers, Jack Klugman, Cass Elliott, Richard Dawson, and Loretta Swit as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
I thought a brief brisk swim before the show would be nice. It's pretty deep pool, though. Hello there. Are they ready, John?
Ready.
Okay, we're ready, too. Are you ready over here on the
line? Yes.
Are you ready on the firing line? Let's say hello to our two players, Eleanor Proley and Bill Goldstein. Eleanor's our current champ. She's won a lot of money. How much money have you won?
$5,600.
$5,600. What are you going to do with that?
Spend it fast.
You're going to spend it fast? Okay. Well, we're almost ready to start a game. We ought to find out who this fellow is, Bill Goldstein. Tell us where you're from, Bill.
Well, I went to school in Oregon, and I live in West L.A. now, and I teach at a junior college.
What do you teach?
Social sciences. This semester, I'm teaching economics.
All right. Good luck to you, Bill.
I may take that up.
You may take that up.
Great.
We'll start this game right after we finish these messages. That's the way it goes.
Economics.
I know that you and Eleanor will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities, the one who's done that most often.